If you remember, we talked about resource qualifiers in lesson one. The idea is that you can vary things like drawables, strings, even layouts based on qualifiers like language and device orientation. There are a number of resource qualifiers you can use to start changing your UI based on screen size. The primary ones you should use are width, height, landscape orientation, and portrait orientation. Width and height simply mean the device's current width or height, which of course changes when you rotate the device to portrait or landscape. There's also the smallest width qualifier, which is the smaller of the screen's width or height. It's the same in either portrait or landscape, so it's a useful qualifier for controlling attributes that you don't want to vary when you rotate the device, such as font sizes. There's also small, normal, large, and extra large size buckets. These are less useful, and because they don't give you as much control, they're considered deprecated. So going back to breakpoints, say we chose a breakpoint of 600 dips. Once the screen is wider than 600 dips, we want to tweak our UI. For this, we add the W600DP directory qualifier to hold whatever new resources we create. Another good resource to use is the Design Metrics tool on the Google Design website. It lists the screen dimensions and densities for many popular devices in Android, iOS, Chrome OS, and Android Wear. Along with the UI Designer in Android Studio, it's a good way to visualize how your design might need to change to fill up space on, say, a Nexus 9 in landscape mode.